Whoops.
Yeah.
Oh, you're dead.
Okay. Same time.
Six.
Eight and a six. Okay, I'll go first.
What's up, dude?
What's up,
man?
Hmm.
Yeah, we got another person. Probably gonna keep this. It's not a great hand against his deck, but it's not a terrible hand either. I can do some things.
We'll get more people like this, like 9 o'clock.
Oh yeah, oh totally. Well,
it'll all be East Coast guys coming home from the bar. I want to watch some Legacy.
Or you want a drink? Yeah,
I'm good for that.
Free beer.
You can keep?
Yeah, I'm keeping, sorry. So Frenchie was basically saying that you told him that you, like, aggressively mulligan with Dredge, just because, like,
yeah.
you just need to have, like, certain things going on, otherwise it's like you sit there doing nothing, and, like, your opponent can just, like, roll over you.
That's true, and I don't particularly want to slow Dredge at all, so it's like, that's another thing.
Yeah, it's like, you want to be explosive, especially in the first game, because that's the game where you have the biggest advantage.
Yeah. And, I mean, your deck's definitely capable.
Yeah, I mean, off camera, I whooped your butt. I wish it was on camera, but no.
I'm gonna have to mulligan this too, though. Like, there's nothing going on.
Yeah, a-sper's got cold hands, doesn't he? He's just like giving you shit hands.
Putting that voodoo curse on your deck.
I mean, it happens with the deck, though. Like,
it has
a lot of like crummy, like it has a lot of mediocre cards.
It has cards that you don't want to have in your starting hand ever.
Yeah,
it's like
you start with like Bridge from Below
and Narcomoebas.
You're like essentially a card down.
Yeah, it's like you might as well mulligan those hands if they're not doing anything. Unless you have like an LED plus double.
Then I don't mind having it because you have gas in your hand.
Yeah, it's like you're gonna draw four cards and you can put a lot of stuff. Guy had to verify his email. Ninjutsu kid. Good to have you, Ninjutsu kid.
New to the Twitch thing. Welcome, man.
He signed up just so he could get on here.
That's awesome. Welcome to Twitch. It's a lot of fun.
You're at 5, right?
Yeah, I'm at 5. Wow.
Oh, Monster. What's up, Adam? Welcome, man. Thanks for
the law beast. The law beaster.
The law beaster. You might know him.
This is just insanely bad. I'm gonna have to like. It's yeah. I can't even keep that. Like,
what's up, Adam?
Cold hands.
I'm going down to 4, right?
So,
feel free to say
Eugene at our shop, I swear that's like the only way he kept winning all the time was because, man, he'd get cold hands.
Well, I mean, sometimes it's pretty easy, you know? It's like,
well, if he's just cutting your deck, not even like. He's got to have see through vision if that's like.
Yeah, he always wears his glasses, right?
Yeah.
Here to watch the Dredge King, Moreno.
Yeah.
Watch me as I try to
mold the four win. It happens.
I think, ooh. Yeah, was the last Fire Knight mold to 5?
He said he's trying LED Dredge tomorrow at 1K.
Oh,
nice.
Good luck to you, man.
don't do this.
Don't
mold the 6.
Don't
mold the 6.
Don't do that.
When
I'm at 4.
On the draw. On the draw. You're on the draw.
All right, I'll keep this and then I'll scry. And I'll put that up.
All right. Go ahead.
All right, okay.
Off to a good start.
Okay. Play a gemstone mine.
Sure.
Pass.
Oh, let's not use the red dice,
wasteland?
By the way, guys.
Is it hard to see?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I can't tell.
Okay, we'll okay. Use the gray side.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a big one.
Alright, I'll play another gemstone.
Sure.
Pass.
Jeez.
No wasteland.
Have the novelty size one if you need it.
Dredge vs. Miracles. I don't think any of us own Miracles decks.
Is that very telling?
we have miracles. We can put it together for you. It would probably take an hour or so, but if you hang around, man, say again. We'll put it together for you.
If you want to see me traverse Rest in Peace?
They're not even playing Rest in Peace right now. They're playing Surgical Extraction.
All Surgical Extraction.
That's crazy.
Playboy. Okay.
So you go.
So is that saying that the best graveyard hate has been determined in its Surgical Extraction?
Against Black Red, yes. And that's specifically the graveyard deck to beat right now.
Yeah, totally.
Not unless Joe has something to say about it.
You're
all right. Cool, man.
That's why I'm not playing lands anymore, actually, is because there's so much Surgical Extraction going around, yeah. So I'm trying to...
True, especially when you're the one specific...
Are you done?
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay, I was like, what?
Your Life from the Loam.
Yeah, or Punishing Fire or whatever.
Yeah.
You know.
This is, okay, how big is the Goyf one?
Yeah. When Miracle starts playing Surgical Extraction, you know you need to get out of Graveyard.
Let's take a...
You got six.
Better put three in the side. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's crazy.
My house, Lobster.
Apparently it doesn't matter if you're Joseph Moreno. The last big tournament we had in LA, he just took it down. No biggie.
As he
take one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We have another one tomorrow in
Woodland Hills.
Woodland Hill.
Oh, sure.
No, that one is in Studio City.
Yeah. Oh, it's right, Nightmare Smile.
Yeah. Basically LA.
Yeah.
Discard Golgari Thug and Golgari Grave Troll.
Sure. So. Where are you guys watching from?
Well, Lobster's in San Juan, if I'm not mistaken.
I have a blue, try to cast Careful Study.
I'm gonna respond. I'm gonna wasteland the other one.
The gemstone?
Yeah.
Is that three wastelands?
Those two.
I'll just blow out a blue.
Okay. I'm gonna force that. Pitching Ancestral.
That's fine.
Yeah. And you have a blue floating.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do anything. Yeah. alright, so how big is that guy now? creature, sorcery,
instant.
Four. Okay, I'm gonna pass.
Whoa, CLV Flame says he's watching from Basel, Switzerland?
Oh,
nice.
We're checking in. We gotta put that on the map.
Four.
We gotta get a map.
yeah.
I don't know where everybody's been from. That's
wait,
awesome, man.
Did I take it down for the map?
We hear everything's better there.
I don't remember.
Yeah, you've taken four plus two. Yeah.
Okay.
So that's right. Go for it. Slow Dredge.
How many cards do you have?
Five.
Alright. I'm gonna untap Dredge six.
Mm-hmm.
One, two, three, four, five.
No.
Six. Trigger the Mark Amida.
Okay, that's fine. I clearly messed up. But that's not the worst.
So, question for you, Joe. I've noticed you've got your graveyard fanned out, but I've also noticed over the years you alternate from the stack to the fan.
Yeah, no, like, to be honest, like, I just fan it out now because, like, I've just missed a few times, like, because I stacked it up.
So
like, instead of like riffling through it now, right. I'm just gonna lay it out. That's essentially
yeah.
Just so
you
I
probably
don't.
Your opponent probably doesn't gain that much
yeah.
from it.
Well,
honestly,
yeah,
like they're probably corner cases, but it's like most of the time they probably just don't even pay attention.
I,
like
yeah,
okay,
yeah.
You're just
like,
gonna kill
me
or
not. They know what's going on. They know what's going on. If they don't, it's like essentially the same thing.
Yeah, if they're bad and they don't look through your graveyard periodically, then
yeah.
they're just bad and
okay.
it doesn't matter.
No, that's good. That makes sense. I've always wondered, and I struggle to do the stack myself.
Yeah, because
I'm
looking through it. Too, yeah,
exactly.
I don't want to kill as much time, but yeah, I was doing that at the SCG, but like, yeah, I kind of just stopped because I would miss something occasionally.
Nice, Ontario, my Canadian brother. And
I'm gonna go ahead and
my family's from Toronto.
Play Cephalic Coliseum.
Sure.
I'll take one. Activate it.
Sure.
I'm gonna draw. The Judge six.
You're gonna draw.
Two, three, four, six.
So we had an idea.
Second draw?
Sure.
One, two, three.
We were thinking of doing a raffle.
Five, six, trigger.
Having Joe sign some zombie tokens.
That'd be pretty sweet. And then I think Judge four hit.
Mm-hmm.
One, two.
Glad to have you see LB Flynn. Hang out here.
Four.
We were your jitters.
Alright, so. I'm gonna go ahead and resolve. So Narcomoeba, trigger, put that into play, trigger the prize amalgam.
Mm-hmm.
Discard three for the Colosseum.
Okay.
Three trolls.
You got it. You have two bridges, two therapies?
Two bridges, two therapies.
Okay. One came from last turn.
That's fine. I'm going to go ahead and swing with this one.
Okay, second one.
Yeah. Second main phase, I'm going to go ahead and Cabal Therapy, target you, sacrifice the Narcomoeba, and get two zombies.
Okay. That resolves.
I'm going to go ahead and name Shardless Agent. Okay.
Name Shardless with Cabal?
Yes.
Yeah, that one. Okay. Oh, so you had three therapies.
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't see
the
third one. That's fine.
That's a good mixture.
Come right up, Adam. I'm going to be the setup from the commander's chair.
Yeah, obviously, I should have fetched a blue in hindsight, but I thought if I ended up drawing one of my forests or my swamp, then I wanted to be able to cast the Abrupt Decay, but... Because I didn't know which one I would need. If I draw the forest, then I need the swamp, you know?
Yeah.
So I don't know. But I should probably... I ended up drawing the brainstorm the next turn.
Oh, I see. That's why.
Yeah. So like I knew I was pitching force to this, and then I drew Shardless, and I was like, I'm two turns away from casting that anyway.
Yeah, exactly.
But anyway.
Well, I just figured
do you have any...
You have those gas. I'm still thinking.
Yeah,
about
I think you're going to probably
gonna
hit one of these two.
Yeah.
I don't think you'll have Deluge in your end.
Yeah.
I'm gonna.
Or Maelstrom.
I mean, I think honestly, one of these is. This, I'm two turns away from casting this.
I'm gonna take the Maelstrom Pulse. Or, yeah.
Okay.
I'm gonna go ahead and pass the turn and then get the prize amalgam back in.
That's fine.
So how many prize amalgams are you playing?
I'm playing two right now. I thought one you hardly ever saw it to make a difference. So two is actually I think it's like the pretty good number. Especially they play nice with like Street Wraith. So like at the end of their second main phase you can like cycle Street Wraith and then you can potentially hit prize amalgam and then put it in at the end of their end step.
Yeah.
That's
and then
they
can untap on your turn.
Yeah, that's pretty sick. Like
it's kind of like Icarid 5 and 6, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, so, but I saw on the list...
And it's a good mix because if they, like, Surgical 1, you still have the other threat.
Yeah.
So that's why you're up to a 2-3 split?
Yeah.
And you're still on there, right? You're not on
the 4? Yeah,
four,
okay. No, yeah.
Go for it.
All right, I'm going to untap.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to trigger Icarid and remove Golgari Thug. And then for my draw step, I'm going to judge six.
Sure.
I'm going to mulligan to four, guys.
Two, three, four, five, six. Trigger mark me, though.
Sure.
That will play.
Comfort's in town. He's actually in San Diego. He was supposed to come today, but he's working, so.
Yeah.
I missed him.
I'm going to go ahead and take one, go to 12, use the gemstone. I'm going to hard cast Golgari Thug.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You do not have a Dread Return, correct?
No.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and Cabal Therapy,
sure.
Target you, sacrifice the Golgari Thug, trigger the Thug, and put an Narcomoeba back on top of my library.
Sure.
And I'll take the Toxic Deluge and get some zombies.
Sure.
Yeah, you're at 17.
Correct.
It's a 4-5. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and just swing the team. 2, 4, 6, 8, 14.
Mm-hmm. Oh, actually,
<I'm> like, <"14?" laughs>
it's one more actually, because of enchantment.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So it's a 5. All right.
I mean,
yeah,
that's
yeah,
better.
Yeah.
You
better,
you don't
like,
want my guy to die. That's the only
die.
Thing. I'll just block a zombie token.
Sure.
And take
12.
Sorry, Dex 12, yeah. Pretty sure I can't win.
Yeah. I'm gonna end the turn, this dies, and I get two more zombies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just scoop. I think if I got a blue, I think I would have been okay.
Could have brainstormed and got
I brainstormed like five turns ago, and then
the Dredge King takes his first win.
Thing is, if I hit a land, the turn after you hit two bridges, like, I can, like, kill my own Glyph.
Yeah.
Like, it's, like, pretty good. Then you just can't
at least
rip
you have
my hand
threat
apart.
At that point. And, like, I have the 3-3 still. Like,
yeah.
That's pretty good. And at least, like, a flyer. Or
but then,
the
a shitload of zombies.
Well,
oh,
no,
yeah,
this
you're in those guys,
yeah,
too.
Well, this was, but I would have gotten rid of the bridges, is what I was saying.
Yeah.
If I had drawn a color source.
That's pretty good, though, to have Maelstrom Pulse and Toxic Daily's
yeah.
main deck.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's pretty good.
I actually have a decent
word
for this matchup,
for you,
too.
Right?
What's up?
Toxic's pretty rough.
Yeah, like, sometimes I keep, like Narcomoebas in play, and then zombies. So if they want a Toxic Daily, they'll kill the Narcomoebas,
yeah.
But then I'll net
that's
then I'll
that's
net
really
zombies.
Smart, yeah. See, like, that's the kind of line of play that I think you only get when you pilot the deck for a long period of time. You know
yeah.
what I mean? Like, that seems so natural for you, but that's something I never would have thought of.
Yeah.
I mean,
the
Golgari
Thug and putting the Narcomoeba on top of the
Liar. No. Just like playing around Deluge by keeping a Narcomoeba or two out just so they
yeah.
can come out, you know, profitable in any situation. Like, that takes years of discipline and practice to know, I don't need to sack this Narcomoeba. I can wait because I'm worried about Deluge and then I won't come out completely empty-handed if that happens.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. High-level stuff. Joe Moreno, Lich Lord. That would be hard.
Lich Lord.
Yeah, Lich Lord.
So I have a lot of cards I want to take out. Not as many that I want to put back in. Jay seems too slow. Mm. Liliana seems
I was like, am I supposed
bad.
To see his sideboard?
I don't care.
It's like having a deck list. It's like, if there's commentary. Right?
For Tormod's Crypt, for Leyland of the Void.
That's what you got. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. For Rest in Peace. We're splashing.
See, that's like the trouble with like Grafdigger's Cage, because he has one. I don't know if I really want to like try to like
play
shove
it.
Like cards to just beat that one, but like I guess if he has Nihil Spellbomb, that makes it a little bit better.
Are you still on the Brutigate plan?
No, that was fine, but it was sometimes hard to get the green and black, like,
yeah.
you know.
It's
but
the cost that's
the best
really bad.
Part of the
and then you have to,
was
you have
that
to
it was
LED. Then you have to play.
Yeah.
You have to play. You're still playing LEDs in the board, or
no,
did you take them out?
LED in the
no, sorry, petals. Still
yeah,
play petals.
Still
okay,
petals,
yeah.
yeah.
It's like, but you're bringing
like
so many
hit,
cards though.
I mean,
it's like you have to bring in so many cards. It's like hard to. You're just like diluting your deck way too much.
So I got inspired to build this deck.
Do you like these? Because then I can hit the.
They're better on the. They're good on the play.
Yeah, on the play. On the play, I think it's fine.
But they're, like, essentially dead after, like, turn one normally.
Yeah.
But I would still do that.
I mean,
yeah, I mean, I need, to, put, I need
to
put something in.
If you take, like, Breakthrough or, like,
yeah.
an LED on the play, that's still pretty good.
The only way that I know how to beat you, and the only time I've ever beaten you, was counterspelling three of your draw, like, discard.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
The only time. That's how
what
the
only
time
like
I beat
I like that.
Don't let you do
it. Like, discard's bad, right?
Yeah, it doesn't hit it.
Yeah, like...
It hits the Cephalid Colosseum.
Beat, like...
Yeah.
Three types of disruption though. It's like if they go like force, like daze,
you
know,
force,
you know.
Yeah,
you
lose.
Yeah,
like,
yeah. But I mean, I didn't need this.
I need to cut
it's
a
gonna
card
be
from
hard
my
to
deck.
Beat
totally,
like,
it's not
if you're a combo deck.
Yeah.
If you're ant or if you're like
yeah.
sneak attack, like that's gonna be hard to beat.
Absolutely. And one of the strengths
of the
about your deck, I think,
Strixes
is that
or the visions. Oh no,
not,
Strix is good because like it always dies.
Usually
like
with you, it seems like the trades are wrong before they realize they're about to get run the fuck over.
Probably
yeah, so I would like,
visions,
you
right?
need to stop that turn one Faithless Looting. You need to give everything to stop that.
Yeah,
or,
the deck
or
has a lot of...
Or whatever, you know?
Right, and the deck has a lot of redundancy, so it's like a lot of draw.
Exactly.
Like, essentially, you will... Like that first game, I was trying to bide my time until I found like Careful Study or Faithless Looting.
Yeah.
Hey, look at that. We got a little famous viewer here. Jay Corey's in the audience. He says,
Serenity
is the business.
I haven't... you know, that sounds like a hot...
What's up, Welcome to the stream. Thanks for tuning in, man. Glad to have you. We gotta get you on camera sometime. You wanna come down? We were actually just talking about this the other day. We need you on. We need to feature your awesomeness.
Yeah, people pointed out how Max was one of your very close friends, and I was like, I've known him for like 15 years. So I mean,
no biggie.
You,
so I don't know.
Yeah, he used to go to TSS back in the day.
Oh yeah, I remember those.
He was like,
TSS days.
He had a crew with like Donovan, the Vest, and a couple other dudes.
That was Yu-Gi-Oh days though, right?
I mean, what?
They didn't play Magic Age. Yeah, did they?
Not True Repair.
TSS.
TSS. The Gathering, as it was originally called.
You played at True Repair?
Yeah.
I did too.
Yeah.
I played Dragon Ball Z there.
I still had to ride my skateboard down Santa Margarita, bomb ass hill.
Oh yeah, thing run, dude.
Yeah, and then get down there.
Oh no, I know what you're talking about. That big hill.
Yeah. And then
that was Rancho Santa Margarita, right?
Yeah, the
Dove Canyon. Dude, saddest thing on the planet. Rubino's closed down.
What?
Yeah.
What?
I know.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, my heart hurts for Rubino's.
No.
I moved away. They were like, we don't. Yeah. We're not gonna get any business anymore. Problem is, it's like, it was really good, but it was like just a little too expensive. Like,
yeah.
It's just like, you just don't get enough for what it is. There's still one on Marguerite, right?
Yeah, but they're all different owners.
Yeah, the different owners.
But the one right next to Chippewa Hills High School was like,
I grew up
there, you know? So.
I hope we're alienating everyone. it's like three people in the room know what we're talking about.
We have one audience member who's local who might know.
Oh, yeah.
Jack,
at least one.
You're going to come? Come join us on stream sometime? Maybe show off some OG Tin Fins?
He has miracles.
Yeah.
A version.
Jake, what are you playing right now?
A version
last time
of
I
miracles?
Saw you were on the Blue Red Delver during Treasure Trees, I think. 8-0-ing an event.
I'll go first.
Yeah.
I guess it wasn't obvious. This is not a terrible hand, to say the least. It's not great.
We're on the play.
It seems fine.
Yeah.
Yep.
Fetch.
Yup.
For an underground, and I'm gonna Thoughtseize you.
Oh, pretty good.
Hope you only have
one
cantrip on the play. Or like LED with like a bunch of dredgers and no way to discard.
Good.
I mean, you can top deck pretty easily, but yeah, just take that. Just play face.
LED to play with it.
Yeah.
Yep. That's what I was hoping for. I hope you don't draw anything good. So you go. No.
Conference. Pass.
Yay! We did it.
Yeah. Yeah, I was hoping if I had another piece, but I thought it was solid enough, because, you know. I mean, I'm not going to ask for more than that.
Yeah, you can't mulligan that.
Draw a spell, and, like, if that resolves, I have a good shot. It's hard to interact with a
Rainstorm?
Coliseum. Yeah.
Can I just keep all these cards?
Oh, that's a solid one.
Okay, so the question here is, what do I put back on top? Okay, my guess is probably this
and this.
Okay, that seems fine. Just because I want to have the option of
doing
either one for this, and I'm definitely playing this. Like, the thing is, I don't need this card right now, and I probably don't
but
need it next
turn. You can do that into that if you want.
No, I can't, because I'm not going to play this. I'm going to play this and this.
Oh, okay, fair enough. Well, yeah, you can. What are you talking about, that?
Oh, with this. But I'm saying this isn't part of that equation, so I can put it last. Like, I can just do this.
Okay.
And then... Like, also, I don't want to have to use this. Like, that's my problem. Is, like, I don't want to have to use it. I want to tap it, because I want to start eating his stuff if he gets it in the graveyard somehow. So, go.
Oh, I took one, right? Yeah.
I took one. No, yeah, that's it.
How many cards do you
have? 4.
Alright.
Like, my sequencing had to be kind of crappy. Like, I had to use my only fetch to get the black source on turn one. And then the Brainstorm, I just had to do it just so I could fill up my hand and try to, like, put pressure on him. So, just... Yeah. No, my sequencing had to be kind of shitty. Like, I was hoping to hit a fetch land off the Brainstorm. But it's fine.
I'll try to... I'm casting Breakthrough where X is 1.
X is 1. I'm gonna force it.
Alright.
Another one. Actually, yeah, I think I have to do it that way. Anything else?
Nope. Go.
So here, draw that. I think I just have to. See, he can flashback next turn. You took two for that, right?
Yeah.
Or were you were 19? Oh, you were 19. Okay, that's
right. First one, and then I just took two.
That's bad. Okay, I think I'm gonna play Shardless.
He resolves.
Alright, go for it. So I figure I have to get more pressure, and I don't think this is going to do anything relevant. Like, he can flashback Faithless, but that's all he's going to do, and then I have two Death Rites next turn. Or if I'd hit a draw spell, then, like, there's potential that I can, you know, do some crazy stuff.
Yeah.
I think because he has the Colosseum, I would have eaten the looting there.
That's fair.
Is it like you're? It's really the well. Yeah,
it's like what's more important.
Yeah.
Like I know most of his hand is pretty garbagey. So like, but the thing is, if he Faithless, then he basically like passes unless he drew something. You know, so it's like I just get to eat both of his dredgers. You know, it's like he has to hit.
Nope, that I go down.
You're 14.
Flash this guy.
Yeah. Like, he's either going to have to strand stuff in his graveyard or just pitch useless stuff. So it's like, I don't know.
What was the name of Dredgers?
No.
I mean, in hand.
If he pitches them, then I just get to eat at least one of them. And then he's just slow dredging, you know, which is, like, pretty crappy.
The sand.
Like, he has to hit a Street Wraith here, which is, like, pretty bad, but, like, even still. Like, I don't know. I lean towards that, but then, like, I figured there's a possibility I could do both. So it's like, I don't know.
Now you really need to draw a green source this turn.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you fall pretty far behind.
And the Thassa's easy. I'm going to take the Narcaneba. I'm gonna eat the Grave Troll.
You gain two.
Gain two. I'm gonna attack for three.
Now, there, since you can't stop him from dredging, it might be better to try and eat a creature coming off the dredge.
I think that's worse. Because next turn, hopefully, I can just hit a land and then I'll be able to maybe eat all of his dredgers.
Yeah.
I see what you're saying. I can eat the Narcomoeba that comes into play, but I don't care about his Narcomoebas right now. Like, go ahead. Like, also, I wanted to dredge land so I can have extra mana.
Just
should I be drunk after one beer? Is that a
dredge file?
Yeah.
No.
Just have to hope
I'm totally
like,
mad.
Super whiffs.
Three.
Jake Ory says best to lead DRS up to eat a land from the dredge.
Yeah, that's true. That's fair. But he didn't hit one.
Hey Shaboogs, thanks
for
calling.
Oh, he did hit one. Oh, yeah.
That's fair, because
then
you can eat the land and I don't achieve the threshold. That's pretty heads up, Jake.
Yeah, he said so the threshold misses.
Yeah, yeah, you're right.
Jake,
that's
what the heck?
That's why
Corey.
He's the Jacob Corey.
Yeah.
That's when you get a the in front of your name.
The, yeah. I mean, I this is still a pretty stretch. Let's see.
I mean, now's your best shot.
Yeah.
Honestly. Thing is, I might be able to just, like, Death Rite, deal him damage for the rest of the game and just kill him.
Yeah, that is true. Right now I'm just playing to whatever I got. So I'm going to take two, because
mm-hmm.
of nine. Cast, Golgari Thug. Mm-hmm. I'm going to Cobalt Therapy, target myself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Trigger.
Yeah, I could eat it. No, I couldn't eat that, but... then you won't, then you won't have, yeah, as you say, then you won't have threshold.
Yeah, that's true. Trigger on the stack. Yeah, because that's part of paying the cost. I'll pay one, go to eight, and then activate Cephalid Coliseum.
Okay.
Oh, jeez.
Thanks for following, CLV Flame. I appreciate it, man. Good to have you.
One, two, three, four, five. One, two.
Kobe says the damage doesn't matter from one attack. Does that make sense?
Yeah, yeah.
One, two, three, four.
We did it, boys!
Hey, at least you kept hitting dredgers.
But like he's probably just gonna die to my board at this point. Yeah, you just pitch all your name. Yeah, name that.
Those.
Put your Narcomoeba on top.
Oh boy. And then. Therapy? Yeah, still right.
No, you said
didn't respond.
Yeah. Not therapy resolved. Yeah. Probably rather have the amalgam in your graveyard, right?
You don't get the
maybe,
dredge
but I don't
trigger,
think it even comes back. Well, I guess
trigger.
It'll trigger off the yeah, because that's a little
what?
More pressure.
What
does that mean? More
round,
dude.
It's
on all
that way.
No,
okay.
It's Nathan.
Okay. Hey, you didn't put the little accent on. I could tell it was Spanish.
Yeah, I guess because then at least it'll, you know, we know it'll
so
trigger off
sudden.
The
yeah,
the
like the second the getting a second and third thug in your graveyard, it doesn't even do anything.
It's just more dredging, but I guess if you have the three and you get a two, it's still a lot of stuff going on, and I can cast it, so I'll just put the amalgam in play.
Sure.
I mean, into the graveyard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is where surgical would be.
It's not the worst. I'm not sure. I think I have to. Another brainstorm?
Yeah.
I should do it this way, not the other way.
I was like, wait, did you just tap your green source?
Yeah. I mean, he's at 8 right now.
Yeah, I mean.
So.
Yeah.
Like,
it's respectable
probably,
to try to drain.
Probably
me.
Just kill you, honestly. If I double drain and attack.
Before you get zombies in play.
Yeah. Put those on top. Actually, I don't need this card right now. Brainstorm's gone. Fetch.
What do you have?
15. Mm-hmm. Devising.
Man, Charlotte's into death right. Oh, pretty good.
Attack for two.
That's six?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This has been a rough one.
Then I will say, go ahead.
Go ahead. Alright. Untap. Ignite trigger.
Sure.
And exile Street Wraith.
Mm-hmm.
Ignite. Trigger Prize Amalgam.
Sure.
Draw step, dredge, five.
Mm-hmm.
Trigger, one, two, three, four, five. That's on the set.
Shabu says you could have discarded thugs and amalgam with Coliseum and named input therapy.
Yeah, you could have done that.
Is that better?
If you wanted to have all of your cards in your graveyard. It's actually fine now. He can cast.
Yeah,
he
like,
can cast his
like
guys. Like
or,
it's totally fine.
Or I can like this. Yeah. Like, actually. Cast like
I'm gonna eat the Narcomoeba.
Because then you can kind of like keep recycling Narcomoebas, but I mean, I don't know that if this is bad.
You are just dead
yeah,
next turn.
Exactly.
If you use
it. So you get two.
Yeah, I already did it.
Oh, okay.
I was at 15. Like, and he has to like, now he has to like spend mana. Like, I don't know.
How many cards do you have?
Two. Like, yeah,
he's still hasn't left yet. He's coming, but he hasn't left yet.
He's like most likely to hit another therapy eventually anyway. Nice. Yeah, he had three more.
I'm gonna try to cast stuff and like into getting shot in the face with death ray.
But you have to win this turn anyway. Like, I can just drain you, double drain you next turn.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, I don't think I can do that this turn. Yep. Attack.
It's like I could block, but I'll just take three.
Yeah, I don't think it's gonna matter. Yeah, you got it.
Okay. Because, like, I can even let the Narcomoeba resolve, and then even if you cast something, then I just eat the Dread Return, and then, like, you just can't do anything.
I was trying to think. It won't matter, because I can't beat, like, the drain.
Yeah, you can't, like, you can put a million dudes on the ground, but I can just drain you.
Yeah, it's like...
It's a 1-1?
There's just too much... I lost too much life.
Alright, Shardless Bug and LED go to a LED Dredge. Go to game 3. Trabug says a double DRS is an uphill battle for Dredge in any case.
Yeah.
It is for most decks.
Like,
honestly.
If you're fortunate with your Dredges, I guess sometimes it doesn't matter, but essentially, though, and did he force a break?
No. Yes, he did.
Yeah, I forced break.
Thoughtseize
your Faithless Looting, and then force your Breakthrough for 1.
Yeah,
that was pretty brutal.
Stopped your action and then had double death, right? I mean,
yeah.
That's the plan.
Yeah, exactly. Like, if you execute it the way,
Your opener didn't help, he said.
I kept it because, like, the Cephalo Coliseum is really hard to interact with, so... And I mean, like I said, the deck is so redundant, like, I'll just, usually you draw into another draw spell or... but it's just like, that's how high I value the Coliseum.
Yeah.
I mean, he has to have the Force too, so, I mean.
Yeah.
All I have to do is get it off once.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, also if you draw like LED with that hand, then it's like insane. Like, you have a lot of really good draws with that hand, like almost any card in your deck besides a land or something, is like really good.
Yeah. Well, yeah, and it being draw 3 too is really relevant, right? Instead of draw 2.
Well, Cephalo Coliseum is just an amazing card.
Yeah. It's pretty, I consider one, it's pretty busted. It's almost as good, like Breakthroughs is just like the best one. But.
And it's interesting that it's the best one, but you only play 3. I mean, one on the side, granted, but.
Yeah, it's sort of like, because I feel
multiples are worse.
3, I guess I only ever want it because I really want to see it against, like, combo. Just so I can try to just. Just wreck their hands. Yeah, that one turn I need the Breakthrough to go off.
So that's really the key with Breakthrough, is it your fastest way to go?
Yeah, because, like, essentially with Lotus Petal, you can go, like, turn 1, like, play a land, careful study, and then if you play a Lotus Petal, crack it, and then Breakthrough on that same turn. And, like, as long as you've been, like, a 6 and a 5 or 2 6s, like, you should be golden.
Yeah.
Okay, nice.
Yeah. Being on the play will help you a lot, obviously. Like,
yeah, that's what I'm hoping,
Did you draw 4 lands that time? That was what your hand had? 4 lands?
He kept a 2-lander, and then he drew...
2 land and Cephalid Coliseum, and I was just,
yeah.
The extra land I drew was, like, probably just naturally drawn.
No, but he's just asking how many, because you, like, the opener didn't help, that you had lands, and then you drew some more lands. It's like,
that never
helps. That never helps, but it happens.
But he had, like, combo in his hand, right? He had the Faithless Looting into Dredgers, right?
Well, the thing was, like, when he tapped out to play Shardless, I was actually, like, fine with that. Like, because, I mean, other than, like, Deathrite, I don't really think I would have cared what he hit.
Yeah.
Well, I was hoping to hit a draw spell to into a land. So then I would be building my board and also have a Deathrite Shaman in,
Yeah.
Obviously, it didn't work out that way. I just hit the second Death Rite Shaman, and it was good. And it was like, whatever. Alright. I almost drew from your deck. That's how you win games, boys.
Yeah. I'll be on the play.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's not good.
Basically, can't ask for...
It's like when you have these two, they're like essentially like two dead cards.
Narcomoeba and Bridge.
It's a Bridge from Below and a Dread Return. Like,
yeah.
They don't do anything in your hand,
nope.
So essentially it's like
Unless you have an LED, then like it's really bad.
It's
in your
funny
opener.
Because I only play the one, but like you'd be surprised how many times I see it in my hand.
Yeah, like you'll see like Dread Return, a Bridge, an Narcomoeba, and like a Golgari Thug, and you're like, what?
Yeah.
Kind of. What are these cards? What do they do in my hand? Nothing is the answer. All right.
You want to cam next with Esper Stoneblade?
Yeah.
Yeah. Sweet.
We'll see how the sideboard works out. Like, yeah. Alright. I think that's one of the hardest things to do with this deck is like...
Oh yeah, like I was playing that deck and I was like, how do you ever sideboard?
Yeah.
It's like...
It's a pain in the ass sometimes because it's like a lot of hedging. Sometimes you just have
yep.
to like be fine with losing a certain way just because, you know, you have to give yourself the best chance, especially like when you're on the play, like you said.
Yeah.
Yeah, this hand's not keepable either.
Them cold hands!
Yep. That first game won though, right? Like,
mm-hmm,
It might be a lot tougher though with the graveyard hate. I'm going to 5.
Yeah, it's just like, I took out a bunch of like very useless cards and put in like slightly more useful cards and then very good cards. So like, I'm drawing a lot less dead cards in game 2 and 3.
Yeah.
But like... You potentially board in answers, you know, so it's like, that's the thing,
oh
it's like...
Oh my god. You're just like, oh, he wants to, it's like, this is garbage.
Yeah, it's like, oh my god.
That's pretty bad.
Cold hands, a-sper.
You know, like, I think that's why, you know, when you play over, in a GP, that could be pretty tough. If you're like,
yeah.
if shit like that happens.
Yeah.
That's like an easy loss in a match sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, that's why you see people take decks that are very consistent to
yeah,
like big tournaments.
To play
it's like
Brainstorm.
Yeah, it's like I want to play Brainstorm. I want to play enough lands that I never, you know, never miss a land drop that I need.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I mean, it's just how you like to play.
Yeah, it's like sometimes you just want lopsided matchup, and you know. Instead of playing something that might be like 50-50 against everything, you just want like to be just like really good against a good majority of decks.
Yeah, it depends what you're trying to do, honestly.
Yeah.
If you're trying to spike a tournament, you want to have the best deck in the room, if possible. But like,
Jesus.
if that consists of you having, you know, a game here and there that you just lose to your deck mulliganing to itself, you know, it might be the right choice.
It's pretty bad, I think. Damn, this is so bad. This is so bad. I'm gonna go to 3.
Jesus.
That's the least impressive. I don't even know what I'm hoping for here. At least a draw spell for something.
I mean, you just faithless looting LED land, right? And then hope you loot into 2 dredgers.
Yeah, that'd be pretty.
That'd be pretty gross. Yeah, I mean. Or
how much I'm shuffling.
LED
shuffling.
Faithless Dredger is enough. Just go LED Sack for Red.
Alright, I'm going to keep that and then Scry.
Okay. you get a Scry on the play.
Okay. Jeez. I'm going to just pass the turn.
Alright.
It's pretty bad.
So, since you didn't do anything, this could be really bad. The question is...
Scared of my 3-card hand?
No, it's just funny because I have a thought to you.
Jisuke, that is correct. The mulligan is the most devastating... That's what takes me out, like, the majority of the time out of a tournament. It's like the deck loses to itself.
Yeah.
Yeah, Lobster, Zigzag is definitely still a deck. It's a very real deck, actually.
Yeah.
It no longer plays the World of Order Dragon,
yeah.
But it plays some other nasty creatures that are just as miserable to deal with.
I know you know what your hand is, but in your opinion, you mold down a 3.
Yeah. I would not guess that.
Okay, yeah, it seems right.
Just keep 3 passes.
Because especially since I have a good
yeah,
play, so it's like... Go ahead.
So Shaboog's
and you kept yours on top or bottom?
Eldrazi versus Dredge.
We could.
Yeah,
I bottomed it.
You bottomed
we're
gonna
do
it.
Okay.
So
we'll definitely do an Eldrazi versus Dredge for you, Shaboog's. Hang in there.
Play Coliseum and pass.
Okay.
You said Cody was on his way?
Yeah, he hadn't left yet. But he's like, I don't know what to bring. I'm just like, dude, get your car, bring your fidget cube, go get your food, just get
we're
out
of here. We're just playing
your legacy,
dude.
Come down. Sorry.
I'm about to get a wrench on Mold of 3. Come on, let's make the magic happen. Like, we did it on Mold of 4. I think I just lost here.
I will say go ahead.
Go ahead. Jeez. I think we should save the chat the pain. It's pretty bad. Alright, let me just draw a card here.
Of course, it's wrecked.
Right.
We got two. We got a double request for Eldrazi for Strange.
Okay.
So we might have to do that.
That sounds good. I think the only person I played against was your Corey's brother, like a long time ago.
Yeah. Cool. Brent doesn't play anymore, really. Well, every weekend he's hanging out with his girlfriend.
Cast Faithless Looting.
Yeah, that resolves.
This and that.
Sure.
And I am Dunzo.
Try to get your Death Rush on.
I'll pay 2 Cycle Street Wraith.
Mm-hmm.
Dredge 4.
Sure.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Sure.
Go for it. Oh, God, cage too. Hey, if it was just Death Ray, I think it was doable.
Brainstorm?
Hey, go for it. I'm more than 3.
Yeah.
Okay.
Get those out of there. You have 1 other card in hand, correct?
2.
Well, I'm saying one besides the...
Yeah.
In all fairness, if that hate wasn't there, then Dredge would just own every tournament. Right?
Yeah. That's why I don't see the hate, I just roll over.
Yeah.
I mean, I just roll the opponent.
I'm going to exile Faithless Looting, deal 2 to you.
Because
yeah. he can't get Icarid anyway, and...
There's a Street Wraith.
He can't...
No, that's Cage, there's also Graphic.
Oh no! Wait, it goes through Cage, right? Because it doesn't cast it. Or no, it's can't enter.
No.
It can't enter. It's like you can.
Yeah,
he can't flashback either, actually, so it doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
But if he like kills this, then he could potentially flashback.
And he doesn't even have a dredger in the yard, so it's like.
Well, not. I know he doesn't have a dredger. Yeah, I don't really care about
this
him.
This is actually terrifying.
What do you mean? It's terrifying.
I'm
to
just
be in
your
seat. Game 3.
What happened?
I just said go.
Oh.
He's just saying like my board and like
it being game 3.
You're in a terrifying position to overcome, basically. You got some hoops of fire to jump through.
Yeah, there's a lot of hoops.
But this is gonna be like the story for Dredge, right? Like game 1's the cakewalk. Game 2 and 3 is where you really, sure
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, ideally I want a little more resources, but
yeah,
that's the gist of
sure.
it. Jeez.
Cascal Garth.
I think so.
One, two. Sure.
Because all I have is like just setups, and that's it. Go.
Fetch and set.
Yeah. What you, so you're at 3 fetches?
Yeah, 3 fetches, sorry.
Yeah, because the only way I can generate zombies through the cage is like. Yeah, like. If I had Hardcast, a Thug, or an Arc Amoeba, and then Dredge into like some amount of therapies, but that's still
therapy.
Like very long winded.
Yeah,
I'm just waiting for like a Tarmy Boy, essentially. So I can just scoop.
Fetch again. Play Shardless. I like this interaction doesn't hurt.
You're like Shardless into a cage. Oh, the dirtiest.
Although, if it's a creature, right?
No, because it exiles it, and then I cast it from exile.
Oh, okay.
It doesn't actually cast the card from my deck.
Oh, collected company. Collected company is different because it's actually putting it into play from.
Yeah.
Yes, you reveal the cards. They're still in your graveyard, or they're still in your deck, and then you cast it from your graveyard.
Yeah.
Nope. Cast Burn Song.
Not a bad one.
Under your.
Yeah.
The cage was a one of, but I mean that's all it takes normally.
Yeah, it's like
sometimes I don't really like playing around the one. I hate boarding and like say like I wouldn't board in like four Nature's Claim just to beat the one card. I mean I wouldn't, but you could. I'd rather.
That deck in particular, you're not like drawing off the top of your deck. You want it to go into your graveyard from the top of your deck.
So you go.
Yeah. So that, like Ancient Grudge can't hit.
Yeah.
I know. Oh, yeah, well, there's always Ancient Grudge, so.
Yeah, you still can't flash it back.
Well, if I just.
If he can't hard cast it, because he's drawing right now. I can't respond to the cycle.
Yeah, I'm just.
Well, it's part of the cost is discarding it, right?
You can respond.
I can respond to the cycle, but I'm saying there's nothing I can do. He can respond and sack Colosseum if he wants to, potentially, is what I'm saying.
Yes.
There's no way I can stop him from doing that. Okay, so I'll just let it resolve. It's fine.
Gemstone.
Sure.
Yeah. Let's try to grudge it.
Force it.
I think it's over.
You can just mill three.
Go.
I'm gonna. Eat the Ancient Grudge, get out of here. Take two. Play Gorf. Sega.
How many cards do you have?
Two.
Okay.
Goyf is. Instant.
Enchantment, artifact,
creature. No sorcery? No sorcery.
No.
Artifact, creature, instant, land. Okay, so four. I'm done after that.
Draw.
Mm-hmm.
Activate Colosseum, target myself.
Yeah, sure.
Ninjutsu Kid says, for the record, pieces of interaction over 7 rounds of magic, a multi-4, a multi-3. I mean, I don't know if there's more, but.
Discard Cabal Therapy, Bridge. Bridge?
It is pretty resilient.
Sure.
Cabal Therapy target my. Oh, I can't do that.
Yep.
I can't do that.
I'm like.
This is just god
Cast another that. Thug, yeah.
Yeah, go. It's just a moat.
Yeah.
But this is not.
But
I have three bridges?
Swing into me!
I'm going to eat your Cabal Therapy.
Yeah, this too. Is not going to last.
Yeah. Fetch also.
They have one more turn, right?
Yeah, I don't think. Yeah, and I can't stop the death right from doing its thing. Yeah, so yeah, he countered the damnation grudge too. On a mold of three.
I mean, you made my Thoughtseize bad. Like, I was like, I could Thoughtseize him and then just have only cards that he wants in his graveyard in his hand. It's like, it's bad. But I'm pretty sure my
Chris, by the way.
Of course.
These are 10%.
That's why I'm fucking here. I'm just over here like, Jesus Christ, I had one beer and I'm fucking tossed. I don't understand what's going on.
I'm gonna attack.
That's why I asked, am I supposed to be drunk after one?
I know, and I just drank two of these, so yeah.
Yeah, everybody looks a little faded. Bring out the big guns early.
Yeah,
I know, that's why I brought
it. I have two damage, so. So you have to block
energy.
You have to block
new.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm gonna just block.
Yeah, and I'm gonna mill from all the tokens.
Oh, okay.
Those would be a mess.